Vamos, Isolda, our Lord Christ. As we are warmly welcomed by your outstanding churches, we are very, very grateful and impressed with such unforgettable hosting you have offered us since arrival yesterday. In fact, Fall Community Church was established in the year 2001 in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, where quite a number of Sudanese refugees inhabited there. After the ongoing civil war erupted in 1983, we were forced to leave the country. The original name was Sudanese Congregation. At the beginning of its foundation, it was founded by two pastors who are now with us in this successful journey. May you raise up Pastor Hakim so everybody can see you. Hakim Charles. Two, Pastor Julius Badigo.
Hallelujah. Amen.
These were the first pastors founded our church. And our delegation also headed by Pastor Hakim, Pastor Julius, and also Pastor Sept Okidi. Can you rise up so everybody can see you? And then our choirs headed by the church council chairman, Oyet, Michael Oyet. May you raise up your hand.
Yeah, nice seeing you all.
As making our journey clearly serving in Jesus Christ's path, and also among our pastors, we have Pastor Betty, whereby she's also part of the choirs. Now we can look at her, she's there. Thank you. As making our journey clearly serving in Jesus Christ's path, we broke away from ELCA group after we found out that they approve the issue of gay, lesbian, or homosexual marriages. That was in 2009. It doesn't get with our Christianity doctrines as well as our cultures. That was a big shock for our families when they heard that. So in 2010, we came out with the name of Falls Community Church as independent church. We, the people of South Sudan, have suffered a lot during the civil war. We never found rest till we found ourselves in the United States of America. We were persecuted back home because of being Christians. Not only that, they even influenced some of our people to convert into Islam using money and swords. They declared war against us since 1935. Many agreements were dishonored by the Islamic regime in Khartoum, Sudan, in 1947, whereby Arabs intellectuals met with native uneducated chiefs. Also, Addis Ababa Agreement in 1972, which was giving South Sudanese their own autonomy, but also did work. We went through all these plights and suffering till the emerge of Colonel Dr. John Garang in May 16, 1983. With his movement, SPLM, Sudan People's Liberation Army, and movement, whereby we got our independence in July 9th, 2011. Thousands of people died and millions scattered into neighboring countries and the rest of the world. Again, we went into war fighting ourselves when the president and vice president differed politically. Thousands of lives got lost in December 15, 2013. May you pray for our newborn country to have peace and settlement. The main objective and dreams now we would like to share with you is how to help serving God to preach His word and plant it in our people's heart so that they grow in Christ, have love to each other and faith in Him. How to help the new building we have purchased recently in South Dakota called Falls Community Church to stand firm in Christ to help our believers come every day and have them prayers. Their prayers discovering God. The dream to help those kids and students in their education and scholarship. Our dream to help those who need food and water and clothes. Our dream to help those who are sick and need curing. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, these are the issues we are facing now in our journey to God, Jesus Christ. We need His name to be lifted up high in America, South Sudan, and all over the world. The neighboring Islamic country is still following us to leave Jesus Christ, but we will not surrender to any devils following us. So will you help us achieve our dreams, not only here, but even back home in South Sudan, to lift up His name and have His children know Him before the devil takes them. This is what we have, and thank you.
Thank you, brother. Hallelujah. I think it seems very clear now. So the main mission here is back in Sioux Falls and also in South Sudan, because our people are desperate, because I've been in war for almost 35 years. In war, and war is not a good thing. Believe me, if you have never experienced that, but we do, war is not a good thing. So we need your prayer, as he mentioned. And before that, then I will present Reverend Sept to come and give just small a word, and then from there we go back to the choirs, and then you give us the more music. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I think my previous speaker has recited a lot of goodness that you guys have done for our church. And now I want to refer it to God. What has God done that we together could be children of God? If we read the letter of St. Paul to Romans 12, I read only one verse. The first verse. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. You have already known the mercies of God. For me, mercies of God are uncountable. I can't count them. God has saved us. He sent Jesus to die for our sins, and He's still loving us. These are all the mercies. Now, you have shown through that mercies, you have shown the sacrifice of your bodies by helping the service of our church. These sacrifices that you have done is seen not only in Sioux Falls but also back to South Sudan. And with this word, the Bible says, give your bodies as sacrifice. You have supported us, and you have accommodated us, and you have given us all that we never thought we will find in a city not known to us. These are all the sacrifices that we have done to God. And now, as you have shown us the sacrifices of God by being so kind and merciful to us and being hospitable to us, we are coming to share together the service of thanksgiving. We are coming to praise our God. This is the sacrifice. This is the sacrifice that God wants us to give to Him. Sacrifice of thanksgiving and praise. Amen?
Amen.
That's why we are here. We are here together with you and share the sacrifice of thanksgiving. Now, we will be jumping and dancing and clapping our hands and shouting and all with joy for the glory of God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
So we invite you and join us together in spirit and in your voices that we come together as one body and one spirit to say to God, hallelujah and praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you ready for that? Let's go for it. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Yes,
it is the one. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us rise up and praise the Lord. Amen. If you can, you can rise up. If you cannot, you can sit down. But your heart will lift up to the Lord.
I hope all of us rise up together and praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not afraid of the dark. Thank you. Yeah.